Okay, it's been a very long time since I really have done something like this, I admit. And I kind of think I want to go back to these, if not just because it's harder and harder for me anymore to come up with really anything to do videos on. It really is. I mean, look at this, it took me pretty much all day to come up with this. Anyway, what I'm going to talk about here, as you see in the title, pretty much overall in general, is video game movies. Movies based on video games. Now, of course, we're all familiar with plenty of them. For the most part, they're not that good. There's a few that are pretty decent. But mainly, the reason they don't really turn out all that well most of the time is because instead of trying to make a movie that they legitimately want to make really good, they only want to make them because they think they'll make a lot of money off of them. It's pretty obvious with pretty much every single one, the Doom movie, the Mario Brothers movie. They think because these games are very popular and have a large, fan base of them, or whatever you want to call them, player base, that equals that it's going to be equally as successful in movies. But then they forget a lot of times, I think, and this happens with books too. And in fact, this is the easier example to make with books, is because think with the Lord of the Rings movies, the Peter Jackson ones, if you want an example here. They're very long, and they're long for a reason because there's a lot in those books, and even then, they're still not as long as they could be if they were, There's this thing with the movies where really there kind of is a limit to how long you can make them and for how long people are willing to sit there and watch. It's been that way for a very long time. 3 hours is pretty much the limit. And there's a good amount of movies that go there, and of course there's actually some movies, not the well-known ones of course, that do go 3 hours and longer. You can find those. I think it's usually like Bollywood movies that are like that. But for the average stuff, it's like a what's called a 90-minute one or hour and a half. You might get one that's 2 hours and a half, and then you get some of them, the less common ones, that are pushing on 3 hours and might actually hit 3 hours, stuff like that. Now what I'm getting at is because of course, going back to the book example, books, there's a lot to them. Some books are longer than others, of course, Stephen King ones and stuff like that. They can't fit everything that's in the book in a movie. And even then, at the same time, there's stuff in a book that really wouldn't work in a movie because remember, you can't see anything in the book, so it has to be extra descriptive of things, which you don't have to do in a movie, so that kind of helps in a way. But at the same time, as you might know, if you watch a lot of movies yourself or read books, sometimes the transition doesn't work all that well because some people don't get this either. Different mediums don't transition well often, most of the time, into other mediums. Books, of course, there's exceptions to this. There is with the video game one, too, in both ways. Movie to video game and video game to movie. There's plenty of examples of that. Again, this all could be summarized by saying, if it's done right, there's plenty of examples of this. But going back to the book thing real quick so I can get that out of the way. What I mean by this is sometimes the transition from book to movie doesn't work that well because there's things missing and they have to change a lot. One of the common examples, probably some people usually use for this, is Stephen King b novels and books. Stephen King's one of my favorite authors, so I'm definitely familiar with what people mean. If you read the book It and you watch the, it's technically a movie, but even though it was released as a miniseries, the one where it's got Tim Curry playing Pennywise the Clown and it's got John Ritter in it and all that, you watch that. And if you've read the book or you read the book after that, you'll notice there's pretty major differences between the two. And that's where you'll get that old famous saying is like the book is better, or I'll wait for the book, or I'll wait for the movie. Because it also depends on the book itself, some might find it more interesting as a movie than they would a book. But a lot of times there's stuff missing that was in the book. You get what I mean? That's kind of comes back to what I'm really talking about here with video game movies, is that's one of the reasons why they don't really turn out all that well, is because if you think about it, again, this is that thing again where certain mediums don't transition well in the other ones, and part of the reason is because how unique video games are. I've mentioned this before, and technically speaking, video games are probably one of the most interesting and unique entertainment mediums because they combine all these different categories, including one on their own, which movies can't do, books can't do, because turning a page is not very interactive. Video games are interactive, whatever genre, whatever kind they are. Some have more cutscenes than others, but in the end, they're far more interactive than most other forms of entertainment, like movies, the most common ones, of course, movies, sitting, listening around the music, reading a book. Stuff like that. You're not really interacting with it. You're not interacting with whatever you're watching when you're watching a TV show. You're not. So, things like that. And that kind of leads into the problem when they turn it into a movie, is because sometimes, again, I think they forget that because video games are very reliant on gameplay, no matter what kind of game it is. Well, it could be just a first-person shooter, it could be an RPG. It's very reliant on the interactive part of it. That's also the main reason people play video games, of course. So that kind of makes a void in a way. Now, it also helps at the same time you turn a vi you take a video game and turn it into a movie that had a strong base to begin with. I mean, there's plenty of people these days that use examples like, say, BioShock Infinite or the Batman Arkham games, Asylum City, and Origins. In fact, I was talking to on his most recent video, Coach Newman, 32-bit professor, and at one point he mentioned that, and I see what he means because those are good enough. You could actually see those being turned into a DC animated movie. That's how good they are, both between the story and what they look like. You know, I get that when he mentioned that, and it's true. I agree with that. Things like that, if you want an example for that way. So stuff on those lines. You know, they have a strong enough base on there. They have really good characters, really good and interesting characters. The story itself is something you could work with, and you can figure out enough how to work around the lack of the gameplay part, and you have to kind of fill in those voids. That's one of the other problems that comes in, and if not the major problem, is because there's major voids left because you don't have the gameplay part, so you have to fill those in, and a lot of times they don't do it well. They don't expand upon that in any way that actually makes sense sometimes in certain cases, or even does it even resemble what it is like. I mean, just think of it this way. So many people know this, especially if you're into the game series. The Resident Evil movies barely represent and resemble the games at all. In fact, they pretty much don't even have the same characters up to a point. It wasn't until the third one, or was it the fourth one? They're up to six or seven now. It wasn't up until the third or fourth one where you even start getting characters that appeared in the games. You know, it was the first or second one has Nemesis. That's pretty much all there was up to a point, you know. It was quite a while. I mean, yeah, Jill Valentine was in the first and the second one, or I think it was only the first one. It's been a while since I've seen it. But you get what I mean. They really didn't represent and resemble the games that well. And they weren't really trying to do that, you know. It comes back to one of the first things I said is when they're doing this, really what they're trying to do is because they think it has a large player base or fan base, they could just do whatever and people are going to go for it, and they don't actually put the effort into trying making a good movie. All they see is money in it, kind of like the Mortal Kombat movies way back when, although they're actually kind of example, one of them anyway, the first one is a kind of example of a video game movie that's done pretty much fairly well, you know what I mean? There's a lot of people say that is they actually kind of like the Mortal Kombat ones for that reason. They're done a little bit better than some other ones, you know. And because of that, you know, you get these other ones that really you can tell they really didn't care about making a very good movie. They just wanted to make one for money. And that happens a lot of times, not just with, you know, adaptations, of course. So there's problems like that. Here's an example of what I mean. This is a series I used to play a lot on the computer, and it's kind of why I got this. I got it recently. It wasn't that much. But anyway, Wing Commander for the Super Nintendo, which is pretty good, by the way. It's very hard, though. This started out as a game series on the computer, FMV stuff and all that. The reason I'm bringing this up as an example is because those you could actually see, and even back then, a lot of people still do to this day if they played it, are very much like a movie. And it's pretty much one of the few examples of games that do FMV stuff really good that put it into the actual gameplay. You actually also had actual real actors in it. You had Mark Hamill in it. Of course, he's most known for Luke Skywalker, but he also did the voice for the Joker for the longest time. Not anymore, though. And then you also have, I can't remember his real name, the guy who played Biff Tannen. And then you have many other real world actors that are in this kind of stuff in Wing Commander. And it gave the feel that, yeah, this could be a movie, you know? Then, of course, I didn't know this for the longest time myself, but then they come out with an actual Wing Commander movie. It's not the worst thing ever, but it's definitely not that good, really. I've just come across some people that like it, but it's just, it could have been dealt with better, really, is what you could say. And it doesn't really give off the feeling of what the games were like, is what the thing is. And that's another thing that these kind of fall short on. In fact, going back to the Resident Evil one, they don't really resemble the games themselves very much, other than the name sometimes. Yeah, you got the kind of infected T-virus monsters and stuff like that, and Nemesis appears and stuff like that, and every now and then you'll get characters from the games. And you got the mansion, and you have Umbrella. But really, when it get down to it really doesn't resemble the games much, and instead of feeling like they're just copying Resident Evil 2 into a movie or something like that, and going what the game's feel is, turning that into a movie, they just try to do a direct adaptation of it and don't really alter it in the way it needs to be. That's the problem, I think. That's what the problem has been. Now, you might, and here comes the hardest thing to explain. Why is it then that some of these video game movies actually do turn out halfway decent? That one, the only thing I can say is I think is probably because with those particular examples, they cared more about what they were actually doing. They actually did try to transition it better than some other ones did. That's the only thing I could think of, and I've actually thought about this for a very, 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 very long time because I like movies a lot more than video games technically, and of course, since I like video games, I've seen quite a few video game movies, and I have. I've seen the Tekken one. I've seen the, even though I don't like the game series, the Dead or Alive one. I've seen the King of Fighters one. I've seen both the Mortal Kombat ones. I've seen the Wing Commander one once I found out about it. I actually have the Doom one. I kind of like that just in an ironic way. The Super Mario Bros. One, which I like for specific reasons, which I made a very old video a long time ago explaining all that. Things like that. And that's why you really don't get that many, I think, that turn out all that well, is because they don't actually try enough to make it work in the movie film medium as opposed to the game one. Again, filling those gaps, adapting it in the right way. But then you get cases like, say, it also depends what kind of game you're taking it from, too. That's the other part of this, which I'm getting near the end here, the things I want to explain. But let's use the most recent example, really, is the Need for Speed movie. Taking a racing game and turning it to a movie, pretty simple, especially a racing game series that really doesn't have any kind of a story at all. You could put any kind of one in there, Really, the major part of it is it's a car racing game series, the cars, fast cars. You got that right, pretty much you're on solid ground. You just have to have a halfway interesting and, sensible story to go along with it, and you'll be fine. So there's things like that. But here's the thing, and this is the last thing I want to really bring up and mention with this. I've thought about this for a long time too, and it's kind of hard, but really, it seems to me the only kind of ones that you could turn into a halfway decent movie that probably would be the simplest and hardest to mess up are action movies, racing games, and things along those lines. Probably even also adventure games, point and click, stuff like that, because they have a really strong story and characters and things like that, like I said, plenty to draw from. But here's the thing with that. Along when I was thinking of that, and it made me realize and think of this, wouldn't that mean then, probably among all others, the best and easiest, well, maybe not easiest, of course, the probably the best one to go from is an RPG, because you have all these characters you could use. You don't have to make any up because there's plenty. You have plenty room to work in. You could change around a little bit, to fit in the movie. The story is already pretty much written for you. You can use that directly and try to turn that directly into a movie, which, as far as I know, hasn't been done yet with an RPG game. Maybe there's, I just can't think of one right now that I know of, or it hasn't been done yet. And you could alter it a little bit, something like that. It's closer to what a book would be if you were putting it into a movie, you know what I mean? If you get what I'm trying to say here. But at the same time, maybe it wouldn't, because RPGs are so long, there's so much there. It could also have the same problem that, books have sometimes, not all the time. There's some books, in fact, I've actually seen some people quite a lot say that the book was better than the movie. That's a very common one. Or the movie was better than the book, because the movie, because it was a lot shorter, it actually ended up making more sense than the book did. I've seen a few like that quite a lot, because I read a lot and I've read a lot of books, and I've seen some in the movie, a transition in the movie, and they seemed actually better than the book was. Not because they were shorter, it's just because they, for sort of whatever reason, they ended up making more sense in that way. Maybe it's because you could see things. It all depends. An example I like to use for that is, it's one of my favorite books and stories, even though it's a very common one, is Bram Stoker's Dracula. That book, which I have, of course, and the movie, which I also have, very similar, but at the same time very different. There's some things you read in the book, you don't really get all that well, despite how well it describes it, but when you see it in the movie, you kind of get it a lot better and a lot faster. And one of the examples I usually hear, and this is the one I use too, and this is the movie I use for that example in the book, is when John Harker goes to, I think I messed his name up, Jonathan Harker. He goes to Dracula's castle for the first time. He gets off the stagecoach and he sees that, well, it's before he gets off actually. He's still riding down there and he sees this blue flame. It's a circle of a blue flame. The book explains it fairly well, but at the same time, you really still don't get what that is. Whereas you actually see it in the movie and it's very fast and very quick. It's only there for about a second and a half, 2 seconds. But even then, that's enough. You get what that was. Even if you've never read the book, you can figure out what that is a lot faster and easier than you could in the book. That's one of those, that little thing right there is probably the best thing I can use as an example for what I'm trying to get at here, is stuff like that can actually help when you do it this way. But of course, in a game, you still see it and you still interact with it, which is part of the reason why maybe an RPG wouldn't be the best one to go for, even though I thought maybe it would be. For some reason, it still seems to me like an action game, like, say, I have an example here, Vector Man, if it was, it'd probably never be done, but something like that, an action movie like that, or an action game, probably could be a better movie than some of these other kind. You never know. It all depends. And then here's another example I wanted to point out, maybe I think could be interesting, if they didn't take it directly from the game, but made a movie like this. is Geist. You have a physical body, you're a soldier, whatever, things go wrong, and you lose your physical body, you turn into a ghost, and you actually are able to even continue on with what your mission was and actually succeed in it where you wouldn't have been able to. Including all the other squad mates you had. Things like that, if that was kind of done, maybe has more potential than, say, if these other ones did. It's hard to say. And then, of course, this is the last example I want to make here. You have things like this. And I'm thinking maybe this right here could be the answer to making a good video game movie and having a kind of formula to it and actually make it successful. What we have here is, of course, a movie series, Die Hard. This game here, based on characters, events that happen in the movies, this is not an adaptation of any of the Die Hard movies. Not the first one, second one, third one, and not the fourth one, which wasn't out when this came out, of course, or even Die Hard 5 with a Vengeance. It is based on the characters, John McClane, of course, things that happen in the movie, way the movies are and the way they feel, but it has its own story and even its own new added characters. I think, at least to me, and this is the whole thing I've been getting up to with this video here, I think maybe this could be the answer to finally breaking the cycle of bad video game movies, or even potentially could also work the same way in reverse, bad video game games. I mean, be bad movie video games, games based off of movies. I mean, here's an example right here. I mean, this isn't the best one, this one in particular, but it doesn't have to follow the movie because they're not trying to rush it out in time for it to come out there, because it doesn't have to follow the exact plot of the movie. It's based on characters and events that happen in those movies. It has the feel of them, but it has its own story and its own characters and its own kind of identity. That, I think, might be the answer to breaking the cycle of bad video game movies. Movies based on video games. I've been thinking about this for quite a while, and I think that might be the answer. It makes a lot of sense, and it would also eliminate a lot of the issues and a lot of the kind of locked in a box and, chained down to a certain, thing you have to do to make it. I think maybe that would help. Say if they made a Halo movie, they could have characters from the Halo series, they could have, base it on events that happen in the Halo games, but you could have your own characters you could add into it, and you also have the feel of the Halo games, but you have your own story. But it feels like one of the game ones, it would be like what those were, except for it's not based on any particular game, and you're not just directly just, we have this game here, Halo 4, and we're going to transfer it over into a movie and just make a movie version of Halo 4. I think that is the problem. I've said this for years, and for all the movies I've watched, and all the video game movies, and all the games I've played, I gotta say, I've just noticed this. That, I think, is the problem, and I think that might be the solution. Base it on care. You can have the characters, have the feel of it, base it on like events that happen in there, Nakatomi Plaza, stuff like that, and like in this one, for example, and things of that on that level. But you can have your own story in it, and you can actually add your own characters. But it still has the feel of that, because let's not forget the most important thing of this. And I'll end it this way: when you make a video game movie based on a video game, or the reverse, your target audience is the people who like what it's based on. If you're making a movie off of Halo, your target audience is to appeal to the people who like the Halo game. And that's also another hard thing to do. This is probably why another reason why these don't work out well, because when they do come out, when they really don't match the game much, you're trying to appeal to the demographic of that game, or you're trying to appeal to the demographic of that movie. Say if there was a Pacific Rim game, you are trying to appeal to the people who like the Pacific Rim movie. Of course, this way movie video games have always been, that's the whole point. Besides, you just like giant robots. That's enough sometimes for some people, but that's the whole point with this. You're trying to appeal to them and get them interested in it. That is the main target you are after when you make a movie like this. Yes, the Need for Speed movie would also work on people who just like really fast cars, but you're also, because you named it that, and because what you're basing it off of, you are trying to appeal to that demographic of that game series or individual game. That's the other key to this. But I think the thing I suggested might be the answer. You never know. Will they do it? That's hard to say, unless you're able to tell them directly, we make this movie this way, do it like this. This might actually solve the problem that video game movies have had such a long time. I've thought about it, and it seems to be one of the best answers. And if it's done that way, it probably could work out way better than it has, you know? Because let's face it, the ratio of good or interesting or successful video game movies to the ones that weren't is kind of skewed in favor of the ones that weren't as opposed to the ones that were. That's just the reality of it, you know? Comic book movies have done a lot better. Maybe that's what they're doing there. They're doing exactly what I said here. They're not, in fact, they pretty much are. They're not taking it from any particular story or comic issue, although except for like origin stories. But even then, they kind of change it and alter it in a way that it works. So that's probably the answer for those. Works for them. It could work for video game movies and even in the reverse. And we could actually also break the cycle, which a lot of people hate, of very horrendous and just cash in, you know, just for money, adaptations of movies into video games, which I know we all are familiar with, you know. Just like those, there's a few that every now and then you get really good ones, but for the most part they're just average to why even bother? So maybe that might break the cycle and that might change it. You never know. Anyway, I know this is long, but this is the kind of stuff I used to do, and maybe you found this interesting, I don't know. So, of course, say what you think about the whole thing, including that idea I had here at the very end, what might actually be the solution to this. You never know. It could work, maybe not. Maybe there's a part of it I'm missing, and you can add to it. Or come up with your own that is even better. Who's to say? I can only think of what I can think of. So that's it. It's real long, but there's a lot I wanted to talk about. So that's it. Thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you later.